I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Central Valley. It's Riley and Danny here with your announcements for today, March 9th, 2018.
The lunch for today is a baked potato bar.
The Greater Pittsburgh Area Food Banks have volunteer opportunities available on Saturdays at their Pittsburgh area locations. Please email Mrs. Jones if interested.
Attention all seniors. All senior project paperwork is due Monday, April 1st. This includes all items in the senior project packet, including the contract, mentor form, hours log, job shadow form, resume, and essay. The visual aid is due on April 20th, the day senior projects will be presented. All paperwork may be turned in early to Mrs. Jones or Ms. Kostlik.
On March 14th, the Peace Club will host a candlelight memorial service and lantern release to honor the lives lost in the Parkland shooting. It will take place at the CVHS throwing fields and revival is at 6 p.m. The lighting of the candles and lantern release will take place at 6:45. Families of the community are welcome and donations for Stoneman Douglas High School will be accepted. Everyone will receive a candle and 17 lanterns will be released in honor of the 17 lives lost. For any further questions, contact Corinne Castronova.
This is a reminder to all NHS members to check their CV email for information from Mrs. Jones.
Good luck to the girls' basketball team tomorrow when they travel to Cambria High School to face the Forest Hills Rangers at 4 p.m. Tickets are on sale in the high school athletic office through noon today. Adult tickets will be $6 and student tickets will be $3.
That's all we have for you today, CV. Now here's Fun Facts Friday with Mike and Gabe.
Hello, CV. It's Mike and Gabe here with your fascinating facts of the week.
Ketchup was sold in the 1830s as medicine.
Approximately 40,000 Americans are injured by toilets each year.
It actually takes 142.18 licks to reach the center of a Tootsie Pop.
More Monopoly money is printed each year than real U.S. currency.
Well, that's all we have for you today, CV. Have a great day.
Hello, Central Valley. Some of you might know that the daylight savings is coming up.
On Sunday, March 11th, we will set our clocks forward an hour.
Even though we do this every year, some people still don't even know why we have the daylight savings.
Well, Noah, we do daylight savings so we can have one more hour of sunlight taken from the morning and added to the evening. That's why in the summer we have longer days of sunlight.
Benjamin Franklin was one of the first people to suggest setting clocks forward an hour in the spring and back in an hour in the fall.
Benjamin first wrote about daylight saving in an essay called Economical Project for Diminishing the Cost of Light. He thought if people had an extra hour of sunlight, then they could conserve more candles.
Even though Benjamin Franklin first wrote about it, America was not the first country to use the daylight savings time. Germany was the first country to change their clocks in May of 1916.
There are also 70 countries in the world that do not acknowledge daylight saving. Most of these countries are near the equator. Their daylight hours never change through the seasons, so there is no need to change the clocks. Countries like China, Japan, and India are some of the most industrialized countries that do not do daylight saving.
There is even a few states and territories in the U.S. that do not acknowledge daylight savings. This includes Arizona, Hawaii, Guam, and the Virgin Islands.
How about we give them more of an inside look, Noah?
Let's do that, Ma.
In spring, we move our clocks forward an hour. And in fall, we move them back an hour. That section in between, we call that daylight savings time. And, oh, It's singular? Sorry, I mean daylight saving time. It may seem pretty straightforward, but daylight saving time has both serious repercussions and major benefits. In the United States of America, 48 states observe daylight saving time, with Hawaii, most of Arizona, and the U.S. territories of Guam, American Samoa, Puerto Rico, and the U.S. Virgin Islands choosing to ignore it. In spring, the 48 states all jump ahead an hour, and the immediate effects can be disastrous. One study found that the average American worker loses 40 minutes of sleep when the clock springs forward. That means lots of people could be losing an hour of sleep or more on the same night, essentially giving us all jet lag. And sleep deprivation can lead to serious health issues. According to studies, the first Monday of daylight saving time has 25% more heart attacks than a typical Monday. Car accidents go up 17% in the days after time shift. Workplace accidents go up about 6%. Workers are 67% more likely to miss work due to these accidents. Productivity goes way down the first Monday after daylight saving time. Daylight saving time isn't even universal. Fewer than half of the countries in the world actually use it, and few agree on when it starts or ends. The switch to daylight saving time has a lot of negatives, so why do we do it at all? The real reason we kept daylight saving time and extended it? Economics. Some studies suggest we spend money when it's sunny outside. If it's light out after work or school, people spend more at the shops. From 1968 to 1971, the UK kept their version of daylight saving time for the whole year, and traffic deaths declined by 11% because it was light after work during the winter. Another recent study found that kids are more likely to exercise outside during the winter daylight saving time rather than huddling inside after school. With benefits and negative effects, it's no wonder daylight saving time has opponents and supporters.
Well, no, did you hear that? We're losing 40 minutes of sleep. I think I'm just gonna keep my clock the same.
Come on, Michael, we can't do that. We just gotta get to bed a little early, man.
Yeah, you're right.
And everybody be cautious at work and driving to school in the morning, because when people are sleepy, they tend to be a little bit more careless.
Yep, you're right. Well, CV, have a good day.
Good morning, Central Valley. It's Belle and I here with a special announcement. Starting today through the entire month of April, if you have perfect attendance, you'll be extended an invitation to the Pirates game on May 16th.
In order to receive this invitation, you must be at school and on time every day through the months of March and April. This means zero unexcused absences and zero unexcused tardies.
If you meet these requirements, you will get an invite on May 1st, and only the first 80 paid students will be able to attend.
The final cost is $17, and the school is providing transportation. If you have any more questions, please see Mr. Vakovican or Ms. Milan for more details.
Thanks for watching and have a good day.
Okay, so is this incentive going to make you want to come to school more?
Absolutely.
Oh yeah, no doubt.
Yes, very much. Yeah, I'll be here.
Okay guys, so overall, do you think this is a good idea?
Yeah, I think people always need an incentive.
Yeah, I mean, $17 is kind of a rip off though, it should be free.
I just love the Pirates, so I'm all in.
Let's go Bucks.